Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Today is round 5 of the chess.com Grand Swiss 2019. At the end of round 4 there were 4 leaders with 3 points and a half. Today all of them drew their game, so now there are 7 players leading the tournament with 4 points. Magnus Carlsen is just behind them because today he won a beautiful game against Ganguly. I already uploaded the video, so if you like to watch the game it's already in the channel. And what about my beloved Wesley So? He started the tournament with a Giri, 4 games and 4 draws. Today with the white pieces he played against Jonas Bjerre, young Danish international master with a rating of 2506. Jonas is only 15 years old, of course always improving, but Wesley So needs a victory. So let's watch the game together. Wesley So with the white pieces opens with d4, and here comes knight to f6. g3, this is a strange opening choice, a sort of Catalan setup but without c4. e6, bishop to g2, and here comes c5, attacking the center. Knight to f3, protecting the pawn. C captures, knight captures, and here comes d5. Short castle for white. e5, pushing away the knight, but where to put this knight? To b3 or to f3? Wesley So continues with knight to f3. Attacking the pawn. Knight back to b3 is the most played move and the line where white scores better, but this doesn't mean that knight to f3 is a bad move. Possible to advance the pawn. Best move is knight to c6, played by Jonas. And here comes c4, good move, attacking the center while the black king is still on e8. d4, and here comes e3. Of course, like before, capturing the pawn will give white a good advantage, because if the pawn captures, there is queen captures, and then black must recapture, or with the king, and then he can't castle anymore, or with the knight, and e5 will be lost. So here comes bishop to e7, he captures on d4, he captures on d4, and bishop to f4. Short castle for black. Knight to e5, now the knight and the bishop are both attacking the knight on c6. Knight captures, bishop captures, and now it's the d pawn that is under attack. Bishop to c5, defending the pawn. Knight to d2, and here comes rook to e8. I have 16 games in my database. Here comes bishop captures on f6. This is the most played move and also the best move. Of course, it's the queen that must recapture. And here comes knight to b3, attacking both the bishop and the pawn on d4. Bringing back the bishop to b6 doesn't work, because here comes c5, bishop to c7, and queen captures on c4, white is a pawn up and also with a better development. So after knight to b3, here comes queen to d6, protecting everything. Queen to d3, connecting the rooks. This position, g6, only one game in database, g6 was played before, but it's not a great move. Rook to b8. Is the best idea, with just a slight advantage for white. Instead, here comes bishop to g4, connecting the rooks. This is a novelty and the game is original. This move is also a move with tempo, because white can't capture here on b7, because there is bishop to e2 protected by the rook. But bishop to g4 is an inaccuracy. Let's watch what happens. After rook to e1, rook captures with check. Rook recaptures, and bishop to b4 with tempo against the rook to save the bishop pair. Here comes the simple rook to c1, and there are 2 pawns under attack, and the black rook is still passive. So, of course, now white is better. Queen to a6, protecting b7 and also attacking a2. Queen to e4 first, attacking both the unprotected bishop, and the second time with the help of the bishop in fianchetto, b7. So the bishop must move back to e6. Here comes knight captures on d4. This b7 pawn is still under attack. Now, capturing with the bishop on c4 is a blunder. Let's watch what happens. After bishop captures on c4, the simple knight back to f3 wins a piece. In this position, black, of course, can already resign, because also rook to c8 doesn't work, because the bishop can't move away, is pinned, because the rook is unprotected, so the simple b3 is enough to win the game. So, going back to our game, after bishop to e6 and knight captures on d4, here comes rook to b8, probably one of the best moves. c5, good move. And here comes bishop to d2. This is a real mistake. Rook to d1 attacking the bishop. Bishop back to h6. And now let's stop and let's analyze c6. That is not the move that Wesley So played in the game. What happens with c6? C6 is surely a good move because this connects the queen and the bishop. Now b captures on c6, knight captures on e6, f captures, and the queen recaptures with check, also protecting a2. After king to h8, the bishop can also capture on c6. White is winning the game because it's two pawn ups. But Wesley So found something even stronger. Let's go back to our game. After bishop back to h6, continues with the direct knight captures on e6. Now, if black recaptures with the queen, what happens? It happens that there is queen captures on b7, threatening the rook. The rook, of course, can't capture because it becomes checkmate. So, after queen captures on b7, rook to e8 is the best idea, but here comes c6. C7 will come, and it's already plus 7. What happens in the game? It happens that after knight captures on e6, black recaptures with the f-pawn, but this move doesn't change the story of the game. Here comes a3, and why this move? Let's go back one move. The most, probably the most precise continuation is rook to d6, attacking the queen, also disconnecting the queen from e6. Queen captures on e2, protecting e6. Rook to d7, now attacking b7. Queen to b3, protecting everything, but here comes queen to e5, attacking the rook. Rook to e8, bishop to d5, now is crashing because the pawn is pinned because there is the unprotected rook behind the pawn. Queen to d1, we check. King to g2, queen to g4. Then rook to d8, and in any case, the black queen is lost. After rook captures, there is bishop captures on e6, we check. And of course, if the rook didn't capture, moves back, there is still this bishop check. Let's go back to our game. We said here comes a3, only played to prevent this queen captures on e2, protecting e6. Rook to f8, and now rook to d6 comes to the board. Queen to b5, queen captures on e6, we check, king to h8, and now queen to e7, attacking the rook. The rook moves to g8, but now after rook to d8, black resigns. Let's watch a possible continuation. Now, what to do? If the queen wants to protect the rook, for example, with queen to c4, queen to b3, here comes the simple bishop to d5, and it's game over. After rook to d8, if b6, for example, here it's a simple checkmate. Rook captures, we check. King to g8. Now, bishop to d5, we check. King to h8 and queen to f8, e checkmate. Going back to rook to g8 in the game, there is another winning line that is nice to watch together. Let's go back to the game. We said after rook to g8, instead of rook to d8, possible to play rook captures on h6, and black can't capture the rook because let's watch what happens. If g captures on h6, there is queen to e5, we check. Rook to g7 is the only move, and here comes bishop to d5 controlling g8, and the white queen can't stop this queen check from b8. Now let's play a free move, queen to d7, because there is nothing to do. Queen to b8, we check. Of course, if the queen interferes, there is the queen capture first. But the end of the game will be here on g8. A very nice short game played by Wesley. It was a Wesley So old style, a strange opening, but with some poison, and then a simple win. I hope that you enjoyed the game. Don't forget to also watch some of my other videos, because I follow all the top chess tournaments. Our analysis is over. I thank you very much for watching, and see you tomorrow. Goodbye.